Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a website in Amazon AWS. You will need an AWS account, and if you don't have one yet, you can create a free AWS account as I showed in another video. So on your browser, go to aws.amazon.com, then log in with your username and password. It will take you to AWS Management Console. You can quickly create a website by launching an EC2 instance that is pre-configured for web hosting. Go to EC2 and click on Launch Instance button. That takes you to Amazon Machine Images. Select AWS Marketplace on the left side pane. I want to create a WordPress-based website, so I search the word WordPress. There are a number of free tier AMIs that are pre-configured for web hosting, and most of them are Linux-based. Select one of the Amazon Machine Images, and on the next page, select Continue. The next page shows a list of instance types. Select the one that is under free tier. To make your website available on the internet, your instance needs to have a public IP address. So enable public IP on the next page. Next, on the add storage page, take the default storage size and go next. Here you can attach tags to an instance so that you can easily find it. If you want to limit administrative access from specific IP address, then list that IP address on this page. For this demo purpose, I leave as it is, which is 0.0.0.0/0, and that means I can connect to this instance from any IP address for administrative task. When you launch the instance, it asks you to create a new key pair or use an existing key pair. This key pair can be used to connect to the instance for administrative tasks. After the key pair is saved, select Launch Instance. It will take a couple of minutes to create the instance. When the instance is ready, it will change the status from initializing to 2 of 2 checks. AWS assigns a public IP address to your instance. You can see that public IP address at the bottom of the page. Also, you will see a public DNS name for your instance. You can use either the public IP or the public DNS name to browse your web page. If you register a domain name, then you can connect the domain name to this public IP address and browse your website by using your domain name. So, a simple WordPress-based website has been created. You can customize this website by logging in with a username and password. To get the username and password, go to Action in AWS and from Instance Settings, choose System Log. My instance is a Linux machine and I can see its system log. So scroll down and you will find username and password near the bottom of the log. You will see the username as user and a randomly generated password. Go to your website and click on the login link. Then use the username and password that you got from the system log. You will be at the WordPress dashboard. You can change the overall appearance of the website by activating a different theme. You can customize the site and create posts and pages. By default, there is a post called Hello World. From the left side tab, select Post and select Hello World. Change the title, change content, and add an image to the post. You can attach a link with the image so that when a visitor clicks on the image, it will be taken to that link. When I'm done editing the post, I update it. So when I visit the site and click on the image, it takes me to that video. Then I create another post and test it by visiting the website. To customize the website, select Customize from the dashboard. You can change its title, tagline, color scheme, menu, and so on. I changed the home page from post to page. So when the users visit the website, they will see a specific page at the home page instead of the latest post. That is the end of this demo on creating a simple WordPress site on Amazon AWS. You can do much more with your website. Because I'm using a free AWS account and there is limit on how much resource I can use, I will remove the resources that I am using from AWS. So I go to AWS, select the instance and terminate it. I also go to the billing tab and check if I have been charged for anything. I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel and set up a notification by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.